Have you ever started playing a video game and then suddenly hours have gone by? You forgot to have dinner, but you don't really feel hungry or tired. What just happened? Did you throw away 3 hours of your life? Psychologists call this experience flow. And even though video games get a bad rap, research out of UC Riverside suggests that they're not a total waste of time. The concept of flow was first identified in the 1970s by a psychologist named Mihai Csikszentmihalyi. He saw the way that artists would become completely absorbed in their process. As they worked, everything seemed to disappear around them. Nothing else mattered. And then when they came out of that state, they felt refreshed and energized.
They continued to navigate, if you will.
Not at all exhausted, like you might expect from this hours and hours of intense work. And so he called this experience of getting in the zone, of being completely immersed in some kind of activity, as flow. It's a flow state, we call it.
This is Kate Sweeney. She's a psychology professor at UC Riverside, and she studies waiting and how people deal with uncertainty.
Whether it's news from a job interview or a medical test or a college application, it's a really stressful experience. It turns out that as humans, we're not that great at coping with waiting.
Kate wanted to see if being in a flow state would help people deal with the anxiety around waiting. So she found 290 undergrads and put them in a somewhat stressful situation.
So we thought, what do college students care about? Well, like most people, college students probably care about whether their peers find them attractive.
When participants arrived in the lab, they'd get their picture taken, something they weren't expecting. And then they were told that other students will be rating them. Don't worry though, no one actually rates the photos. But the situation gave Kate and her team a chance to see how people react to a little bit of stress in the lab. So while the participants waited for their supposed rating, they got to play a game. The classic 80s video game, Tetris.
Video games are one of the best ways to get into flow. We know from lots of research that flow is most likely to occur if we do something that's hard, that's engaging, that's active, not something that's just passive, like sitting and watching TV, scrolling through social media.
A good flow activity has clear goals. It'll push you a little beyond your skill level and give you immediate feedback on how you're doing. You can see how a game like Tetris taps into all this. Kate's lab broke the participants into three groups, who each played different versions of Tetris. One played it the normal way, where the game gets more challenging over time. Group two got an easy, but extremely boring version of the game. And the last group played an almost impossible version, where the blocks fell super fast. It's hard to get into a flow state if an activity is too easy or too difficult. And Kate's study confirmed this. The people who played Tetris the normal way reported a lot more flow than people in the other groups. And they also felt less worried and were just more at ease while they waited to hear their rating. So it wasn't just any distraction that helped with anxiety. It needed to be something that activated the flow state. Something challenging, but not too challenging, that gives you feedback on your progress.
One of the great things about flow is we can all do it. And flow is really personal in some sense. It's a match to what you find interesting and enjoyable and challenging.
This is something we saw during the early days of COVID quarantine. People got really into activities like baking or hiking, and jigsaw puzzles went up in sales by 300%.
People may not have known to call that flow, but I have a sense that people were seeking that effect of flow that would make that period of uncertainty and isolation pass a bit more quickly.
And while flow can reduce stress, it's also worth remembering that worry does serve an evolutionary purpose.
Worry is actually our friend. Worry is really useful in helping us to pay attention to threats that might be coming in the future. It keeps our mind, annoyingly but helpfully, on those threats. It gives us the motivation to try to prevent bad things from happening or prepare for them if we can't prevent them.
Worry pushes us to study for that test, to wear our seatbelts, to see the doctor. But once you've taken action, you don't want worry to consume your life. That's where a good distraction can help relieve your stress. Doom scrolling or binging a show won't do it though. Humans like a little challenge, and that includes a good video game. So how do you find your flow? Let us know in the comments. And be sure to check out our other video on why our brains fixate on negative thoughts and what we can do about it.